सही मार्कर काम नहीं कर रहा है, ये देखो कैसे आ रहा है, मार्कर काम नहीं कर रहा है, इसको बंद करना पड़ेगा। रेड नहीं है, रेड ब्लू हो,
ब्लू
Sorry for this inconvenience. So, note on the question number 37. Question number 37. Question number 37. Hello? Okay. The hysteresis loop of magnetic material has an area of 5 cm square with the scales given as 1 cm, 1 cm equals to 2 ampere turn. And 1 centimeter equal to 50 milliweber. At 50 hertz, the total hysteresis loss is how much? You need to calculate. So what is given in the question? That is, area, hysteresis loop area is 5 centimeter square. That is, hysteresis loop area, okay, and 1 centimeter that is given 2 ampere turn, and 1 centimeter is given that is 50 milliweber. Is it clear? And you know how you can get the hysteresis curve? It is nothing but a VH curve. VH means magnetic flux density, and H is the magnetic flux intensity. It is clear or not? Okay, so this area is captured by this loop is known as hysteresis loop area. Is it clear or not? This dashless line, you are seeing that area is known as hysteresis loop. And hysteresis loop area is known, gives us the hysteresis loss. That equals to the, that gives us the hysteresis loss in watt. Okay, this is H and this is B. So it is 2 ampere turn. This is NIYL. So it is proportional to H, we can say it is proportional to ampere turn, and this also proportional to flux. Is it clear? Is it clear or not? So flux is in Weber and ampere turn is in this proportional to Ni and this is ampere turn. Is it clear or not? If we multiply these things, we can get the area. Okay? The total area, how much it is? Total hysteresis area is, that correspond to 1 centimeter square, 250, that is 100 milli, 10 to the minus 3. okay, Weber into ampere turn. Is it clear or not? Since the area of hysteresis is 5 cm square, so 5 cm square is multiply 5, that is total we got 500 but this hysteresis loss area we got per cycle. This the curve for one cycle. So what we can say, hysteresis loss per cycle is 50 hertz. Since the frequency is 50 hertz, it means there are 50 cycles. So per cycle we got, that is 500 10 to the power minus 3 Weber into ampere turn, right? Now for the 50 cycles, what will be the total hysteresis loss? Total hysteresis loss would be 50 cycle 10 to the minus 3 multiply with 50. This 50 is correspond to the number of cycles, since we are applying the device at a 50 hertz, right? This is Weber ampere turn per second. So we got around how much? We got, that is 25 watt. This is how much? 25 watt. So option C is right. So which option is correct? Option C, and this is asking gate 2001. Okay, note that question number 38. Question number 38, what it says, a 3-phase transformer has rating of 20 MVA, 220 kV star by 33 kV delta. And rating is 220 kV star divided by 33 kV delta. With leakage reactance 12, impedance leakage the transformer reactance referred to each phase of LV delta connected site. The transformer reactance referred to each phase of the LV delta connected site. So we need to find out the reactance referred to the LV delta site. LV delta site. So find out this value in ohm, not in per unit. Not in per unit. As you have seen, this is the configuration. Okay, this is the star and delta configuration of transformer, right? As you have studied in the power system course, that per unit impedance to each side is same. Per unit impedance to primary side as well as to the secondary side, Same, it does not change. Okay, so what are the per unit impedance for the primary side would be equal to the per unit impedance to the secondary side, that is delta. Is it clear? So we need to find out the value of per phase. This value we need to find out. Z delta. I hope you got it. So how we can proceed? As we know, per unit impedance remains same. So per unit impedance for Z delta per unit, how much it is? 112%. Z delta is 12%. So if we know the value of Z base value and multiply with 12%, that we will get the actual value. Okay? So actual value Z delta, actual value is 12% multiply Z base. So 112, Z base how much it is? VV square by SV. How we got the ZV is, how we got, that is VV by IV, and VV is SV by VV, so VV square SV. Is it clear? So what is the base value for this delta side? What will be the value of delta side? That is how much? 0.112. VV would be how much? Since phase voltage and line voltage to the delta side is same, it does not change. Is it clear or not? So V base value is how much? That is 33 kV. And for this phase, what will be the S base? S base would be how much for this phase? That would be 20 by 3 because it is a 3-phase transformer, and we are considering a single phase. For single phase, we are going to determine, so 20 by 3 MVA. Is it clear or not? Now put the values. This is 33 K square divided by 20 by 3 MVA. So how much we got? Calculate. How much we got? 19.6 ohm. I hope you got it. You got or not? Okay. Question number 39. And this question asked in GATE 2001. Question number 39. A 400 volt by 200 volt by 200 volt it is a three winding transformer, remember, and 350 hertz three winding transformer is connected in shown in figure. The reading of voltmeter will be, the figure is given in the question, that is and the dot position that is given and this is the position that is given and the rating. So in the equation what we need to find out, the rating of voltmeter, what it will read, reading of voltmeter we need to determine. As you know, as you can see, this winding and this winding connected in series, right? So if it has plus, we take always dot at a plus position, right? This is plus, this is 200, right? And this is plus and this is minus, that is 200. Is it clear or not? 200, so it becomes total 400, total 400. And V1 is the, that is the A terminal and this is B terminal, suppose. So what is VAV? VAV nothing but the reading of the voltmeter, right? That is V. So terminal A voltage how much? That is 400. And V terminal that is given 400. Here it is also given, that is 400 is also given with respect to what? Plus and minus. So what is the value? That is 400 minus 400, because this VA with respect to the ground, how much it is? That is 400. And VB, that is with respect to the ground, how much it is? That is 400. Is it clear or not? 400, that's why 400 minus 400 is how much? 0 volt. So VAB would read 0 volt. So what is the answer? Answer is A. Answer is A. Question number 40. So note down the question number 40. And this question number 39 is asked in GATE 2002. Okay, note down question number 40. Figure shows an ideal three winding transformer that windings 1, 2, and 3 of the transformer are wound on the same case as shown. The turns ratio N1, N2, and N3 that is given 4 by 2, 2, 1, and the resistor that is given 10 ohm is connected across a winding to a capacitor of reactance 2.5 ohm. Capacitor reactance that is 2.5 ohm is connected across winding 3. Winding 1 is connected across a pair winding is connected across 400 as supply. If the supply voltage phasor is V1, that is 400 0 degree, the supply current phasor I1 will be how much? That we need to calculate, right? So how it is? What is the given figure? This is V1, this is winding 1, and winding 2, that is 10 ohm, that is XC given 2.5 ohm. Okay, is it clear? So we need to find out the value of I1. Is it clear or not? Now how we can find out? Suppose the dot convention that is given I1 and here it is I2 and here it is I3. This is I2 and number of turns here, number of turns is N1 and number of turns that is N2 and here number of turns is N3. So how we can proceed? As we know from the MMF balance equation. What is the MMF balance equation? The MMF of this equation would be equal to the MMF of this winding plus MMF of the third winding, right? N1, I1, N2, I2, and N3, I3. And remember, this I1, I2, and I3 would be in phasor quantity, not in magnitude. That's why it is in phasor. That is why it is var. Okay. And what is the N1 value? That is 4. Suppose 4 multiply I1 is how much? I1 that we need to calculate. I1 var. And N2 is 2. I2 we can calculate. I2 is how much? What is the E2? E2 by R. So E2 is how much? 2 by 4 V1. Is it clear or not? That is 400. So we got 200 angle 0. So 200 angle 0 divided by R is value is 10 ohm. So it is 20 angle 0 is the current I2 ampere. So note here 20 angle 0 or N3 value is 1. And what is the I3 value? I3 value, how we calculate? E3 by XC. So E3 how we calculate? 1 by 4 V1. So V1 is 400 by 4, that is 100. 100, this is E3, sorry. This is E3, right? Now what is I3? Or XC value is 2.5 J, that is minus J, okay? This is XC is minus J 2.5. And I hope you know that is minus J, right? So it is 40 angle 90. So how much it is? 40 plus J 40. So what is I1? Tan J1. Is it clear or not? So we got the value of I1 is, we got the value of I1 is how much? That is 10 plus J 10. So which option is correct? That is option C is correct. Okay. This question asked in GATE 2003. Note on the question number 41. Question number 41. Figure shows an ideal single phase transformer. The primary and secondary coils are bound on a core as shown. The turns ratio N1 by N2 given, that is 2. The current phasor of voltage E1, E2 and current I1 and I2 and the core flux are as follows. The phasor diagram it is given and also the core that is given in the question. Okay, and E1 and this is current I1 flows, and E2 and current I2. And four diagrams are given in the question, so which option is correct according to this? So as we have drawn the phasor diagram, what was that? We took the reference quantity, that is magnetizing flux phi. Is it clear? And phi flux, that is lagging by 90 degree from the supply voltage E1. In the previous, as we have studied the course in transformer, the applied voltage was V1, not E1. But in the question it is mentioned that it is E1, right? So it is E1. Lagging by 90 degree with E1. Is it okay or not? And E2 is being induced is in the secondary winding, which is lagging by 90 degree. Is it clear? And since it is a resistive load, so I2 would be is in the phasor of E2, and I1 would be, so which option is correct? Which option is correct? That is option D is correct according to the given figure, right? Is it clear or not? Now move on to the question number 42. This 41 question asked in GATE 2003. Question number 42. A 500 kVA 3-phase transformer has iron losses of 300 watt and full load copper loss, that is 600 watt. The percentage load at which transformer is expected to have maximum efficiency? Maximum efficiency. So 300, that is iron loss. Iron loss 300 watt, and the copper loss, that is given full load copper loss, that is full load copper loss is given 600. Okay, now we need to calculate the maximum, the percentage of load at which transformer is expected to have maximum efficiency. To read the question properly, the percentage of load at which we get maximum efficiency. So how we can calculate? Efficiency formula is PI should be at a load, that is P copper. Is it clear or not? This should be at any load. At any load this should be equal. At any load. And P copper at any load is calculated X square by P copper at full load. Is it clear or not? So at any load, that is factor X. At any load at X. Okay. So PI is X square P copper full load. Is it clear or not? So PI is 300, X square is full load, that is 600. So X is 300 by 600, that is 2, 1 by root 2, that is 0.707, that is 70.7% load. At 70.7% you will get the maximum efficiency, right? So are you agree with this? So option B is correct. Okay.